credit card. Upset. Little dap.
Where's BT Brockmore 10 speed on his way?
I mean, nice.
Damn it. Ooh, that was good.
Did you have your weed?
We cap, yeah, baby.
Have a good one.
Can I?
Happy birthday. I'll be waiting for 3 weeks.
Sir.
We have Tinsley coming. He's here.
Oh, good. Yeah, that's good. Man, I'm going.
Yola.
Got it. Ah!
There he is.
What's up, baby?
Hi, baby. How you doing today? So we can noodle in A, right, Mom?
Yeah.
There's sort of been a separation between recorded music and our live performance. Things change a lot on stage, night to night and week to week. We're not playing to promote anything but the show that we're doing, you know? But the show's been, from the beginning, sort of been our center, the part that's kept us going. There's a freedom on the stage. I was talking to Jeff Coffin, who's the most recent addition. He was saying to me the other day that he's never been in a band that's so open. I like keeping it loose because it keeps it exciting for me. I become part of the audience because the music is different every night. That openness makes it sort of much more playful.
We get out there and we have fun with it, and we get out there and we make sure that what we're doing is gonna touch that audience in such a way that they're gonna leave and be like, holy, what was that?
Dave puts everything into the music.
What he can do playing guitar and singing is pretty remarkable.
Dave has a certain energy, that frontman energy that we need.
He's not a showy vocalist. Like, there are vocalists that are very melismatic, singing a lot of notes off of one tone. And Dave can move around like that because he's got really good control of his voice.
Still to this day, just a magical, just beautiful voice that's unmatched by anybody.
He gets on stage, you know, that nervous energy is there, but I think we need that. But Dave, he tackles that in such a way that it's like, okay, take that. Let's go out here and kick some butt.
Up there is a pretty remarkable violin player. He's also a remarkable stage presence. He's unique. There's something about it comes across as pretty modern, but it's a really primitive way that he approaches that instrument, a really honest way.
I just always worry that he's going to fall off the stage when BT starts a solo. He's got dark sunglasses, and I don't know how he does it, but he gets right up to the edge, and he goes. It's something very unique. I don't think there's another fiddle player on the planet that plays the way he does. If the band was kind of feeling a little drowsy and maybe we just needed something, let's give BT a solo. We can't help but just like,
He'll wake the house up and he'll get out front and he'll do his dance and he'll do his violin thing and get to stomping and twisting, and he's feeling it, you know, and we're feeling it too.
If I'm really there, I don't know it, you know, I don't realize what's going on. I'm just in there just rocking it, you know what I mean? I'm just standing in that moment, and you know, and then after the fact is like, I might go, oh, that was cool, you know.
Stefan is my right arm. We have to lock so hard together to keep the foundation so the other guys can make a statement. When we played the other night, he did something that I just wanted to jump off the drums and just start screaming because it was so incredible.
You were doing that. That was nasty.
Yeah.
Stefan brings that sort of youthful element to the band, you know what I mean? It's just like he's from the skater generation and so forth, and you know, and that's really cool to have him.
Having Tim back, Tim Reynolds on guitar, he's been playing on and off with us a lot, and I played with him for years, obviously. Tim brings this ability to be immediate and conversational in music, no matter how big the audience is or how unusual the music is.
I can't believe sometimes I'm like in this band, I'm playing here with Tim Reynolds, who growing up was like, you know, this amazing virtuoso musician.
Sean was always reluctant to solo. He's doing it more now. He's stepping out more, spreading his legs out a little bit, and blasting his trumpet. But at first, he just wanted to sort of fit in.
When Leroi started having Rashawn come out, that he liked about Rashawn is he was just himself behind the horn.
When Roy was injured, we brought another horn player in. Roy had, with Rashawn, had created this sort of section sound that we'd all started to really get excited about. That when Roy left, we said the one thing we can keep that Roy had brought is this section sound. So that was really the motivation behind getting another sax player, was to maintain a sound that Roy had created.
Jeff Coffin is outrageous. He had to fill some pretty damn big shoes.
A lot of the fans know the music better than I do. I've had to put in, even before the tour started, about a month and a half solid of only working on this stuff.
He's had to learn a lot of music, and not only like lines, but the way the lines were played, the intensity.
Now that Jeff's been out on stage with us for a while, he brings a really different energy, and I think the openness that the band had started to feel for each other again before Roy's accident has allowed us to be open to a really different player. Jeff's brought a really unique voice. Carter and I have a relationship on stage that is powered by what he can do. I don't think there's a lot of musicians in the world on any instrument that can play as explosively and as powerfully as he can.
Carter, you know, obviously is the powerhouse. He's like the rocket engine. He's got the energy, and when he's on fire, you can't help but to just hold on.
I try and be more or less the cheerleader, you know, for the guys, to a degree that allows everybody to just to step the game up, you know, another level.
That was okay, right?
That was excellent.
Man, I had my ears out, so I couldn't tell. If he's really positive, everybody else feels that strength and feels like there's a captain that is worth following. I would say that on stage, Carter is absolutely the captain. It's really unbelievable to watch him play. I've never seen a drummer that can move a crowd just by himself, just move a crowd. People can't believe what they're seeing because you can't, it's unbelievable. And in the middle of all that, it'll blow a bubble. One thing about that I think is unique about this band is you don't have to fit any dimensions or stylistic boundaries to fit into the band.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We all really dig this album, you know what I mean? It's, to us, it feels like an album, like one of the first albums we did, like Under the Table and Crash. It's that same kind of excitement. We kind of like went back to the very beginning, you know, of the way that we used to start, which is like in Dave's mom's basement, you know, all together, like writing songs together.
We've been working on this for about a year, but it's been 4 years since a record. I think we just all knew that whatever happens, we have to make this record together. And it has to be a record that we're 100% behind, each one of us.
Great stuff in that card.
Shoot, yeah, card. Yeah, it felt good. Yeah, that was tight. Can we do it again? Is everybody cool for that? I know it's late, but I'm starting to feel a little taste here.
I don't care.
We brought in Rashawn and Jeff, who are with us playing trumpet and saxophone. Under the Table and Crash and Before These Crowded Streets.
What we had at the beginning was we had this eagerness. We knew we had something that was like nothing else. Audiences were enjoying it, but man, we couldn't clean the toilets in at a festival or South by Southwest, man. They'd be like, hell no, you can't come down here. But then, you know, then there was a few records where we kind of, you know, we went on a little bit of a holding pattern, you know, just, and that was faith. I think that was faith in what we were doing as well. Mm-hmm. But we just kind of lost connection with each other. You know, I think we all kind of bottomed out, came to a head at a point. But then, you know, good friendships and good management, we worked out. We got into a room together and sort of punched it out. And that sort of started happening in the last few years. We started seeing that we needed to do that again. And you know, I'm glad to say Roy is one of the people that instigated this change, changing himself, changing us.
You know, I like Dave. I hate to say this. I like the other part to end on, man. The part that comes, I don't know what you call it on.
Right before that.
What are you talking about?
That's what I like. I think it's better, because I think
it's
better. Shorter.
It's a little bit, it makes it a little less predictable.
Yeah.
You know.
The music started feeling it live, you know, it started happening live. The music started changing again. There started being aggression. We got Tim back in, and there's a whole lot of things started happening around what is giving the sort of the birth of this new record.